In the previous tutorial, we made some custom classes for our shader program, VAO, VBO, and EBO. Now let's finally learn more about shaders. You can think of shaders as functions that run on the GPU. Since they are similar to functions, they can take inputs and also have outputs. So let's take a look at our default vertex shader. While looking at this, you might think it's C code, but it's actually OpenGL's shading language, aka GLSL, which has a similar syntax to C. The first line contains the version of GLSL we are using. Since we have OpenGL 3.3, we need to use GLSL 3.30. The second line takes an input APOS using the layout with location 0. Layouts help OpenGL read the vertex data it receives. In this case, we see that on the 0th layout, there is a vec3 data type for positions. Now for the main function, we simply assign glPosition a vec4 with all our positions, plus an arbitrary 1 for the 4th dimension, which we can ignore for now. OpenGL recognizes the keyword glPosition and knows it needs to use it as the position for the vertex. You can think of this shader as outputting glPosition, even though it doesn't specifically do that. On the other hand, the Fragment Shader specifically says on the second line that it outputs a vec4 color. Now for the main function, we simply gave it a color in RGBA format to use for all the vertices. But instead of having one color for all the points, let's give each vertex its own color. So I'll start by writing RGB values after each position in the vertices array. Then I'll add a second layout with location 1 that takes a vec3 named A color. But since the Fragment Shader is the shader that takes care of colors, we need to output the colors from the Vertex Shader to the Fragment Shader. To do that, I'll output a vec3 named color, and in the main function, make it equal to the A color imported from the vertices array. Now in the Fragment Shader, I'll input the exact same vec3 named color. It's very important to give inputs and outputs the same name, since otherwise OpenGL wouldn't know to make the link between them in the first place. And the final step for this shader is to make frag color equal to color, since that's what we are outputting. Now we should configure the vertex attribute pointers, but first we need to modify a function from the VAO class. Let's change linkVBO to linkAttrib and add 4 variables, numComponents, type, stride, and offset. Now do the same in the vao.cpp file and add in the new variables as inputs to the glVertex attribute pointer, just like me. So we are sending the shader an array of a bunch of bytes. In order for OpenGL to know how to interpret all of them, we tell it how to do so in the glVertex attribute pointer function. First, we specify the layout location. In our case, 0 for coordinates, slash position, and 1 for color. Then the number of components per layout, 3 in both of our cases. Then the type of our components, GL float, and finally the stride and offset. The stride is the distance in bytes between the beginning of one vertex and the end of another, which in our case is 6 times the size of a float, since each vertex has 6 floats. The offset is simply the initial offset of a layout in bytes. For the coordinates, that's 0 because they are right at the beginning, while for the colors, the offset is 3 times the size of a float in bytes, since the first 3 components are coordinates. Now let's write all of this in code by linking the attribute for coordinates and colors from our VBO to our VAO. Now if you press run, you should see that the triangles have a nice gradient of color. You might be asking yourself why there is a gradient of colors, even though we only specified a couple of colors. Well, that's because if a primitive has different colors for its vertices, then OpenGL will automatically create a nice gradient from one color to another. This is called interpolation, and it is used in other things besides colors as well. Now let's look at the second method of getting inputs and outputs within and outside of a shader. This second method makes use of uniforms. Uniforms are sort of like universal variables that can be accessed by other shaders and can even be accessed from within the main function of the program without the use of a VAO. Let's create a float uniform called scale in our vertex shader. Now let's just add to each coordinate the corresponding coordinate multiplied by the scale. What this essentially does is it increases the size of our triangles. So if the scale is, let's say, 0.5, then our triangles are 50% bigger. One thing to note though is that you should never declare uniforms if you're not going to use them, since otherwise OpenGL will delete them automatically and that may cause errors. Okay, now in order to give the uniform a value, we must first get its reference value in the main function. We'll do that by using gl get uniform location and store the reference in an OpenGL unsigned integer variable called uniid. The function will take as inputs the reference of the shader program and the name of the uniform. Now, in order to give it a value, we must use the gl uniform function, but we can only do so after activating our shader program, so make sure you write it after shaderProgram.activate. GLUniform is a bit of a weird function, as its name's suffix changes depending on the data type we are inputting. If you want to know all the variants of the function, look it up in the documentation I left in the description. We are going to use GLUniform1f, since we are only inputting one float, and then for the inputs, we'll use the uniid and 0.5f. Now, if you press run, our triangles should be bigger. As a final step, I will add some error checking in the shader class, since we don't have debugging for our shaders, and so it would be nice to get a basic error message when a shader fails to compile. If you want to know how the error functions work, I left a link in the description to a Wikipedia article on them. Don't forget to add comments to everything to make sure you understand what you've written. And as always, the source code and some exercises are left down in the description. Bye!